Here's one of the wooden pulleys from the workshop, and I've kind of taken it apart, kind of put it back together. You can see over here there are three flathead screws. They fit in here, those three holes. Let me take that off, and you can see the three corresponding holes where those screws would have fitted in. And you'll see where they fit in. You can also see that this section is curved, and from what I can determine based on the saw marks, this was glued together, this section here, and then was bandsawn to give the curve. And you can see there's four bolts poking out. One of them is taken off. Let me see if I can get this apart one hand. It's always fun. So you can see there's half, and there's those three bolts I talked, or three nuts I talked about. Inside there's the wooden sleeve that actually fits the specific diameter of the shaft. And there's those four bolts. And those four bolts seem to be put on first, and then this section is glued. This section is glued to this. Now, this pulley is old enough and it cracked. And so we can actually go in and see that there's the glue line. And you can see the bolts were put through initially. Then this section was glued to here. Let me just restore that. So now we had four bolts, and then a companion piece, this section, was made. Four bolts sticking out. Then I believe this was bandsawn, and then later these countersunk holes were made for the nuts. This was then put on, and then those three flat-headed bolts were then inserted, and the whole thing was screwed together. And I believe this section was put on after it was mounted on the shaft, because there's no other way to tighten this thing onto the line shaft. So this had to be open. This section had to be open before, so that they could tighten it, and then this cap, in effect, was put on after the line show. So I'm not sure how they got this thing round. So maybe there were some issues on that, but it's not a high speed. So there you have the pulley. So here we are doing the next final machining on that wooden mandrel. South Bend, just to get a little bit more, just easier to deal with rather than giving that big machine. And frankly, it's also a little higher speed, so that the finish on this thing is real, real smooth. You see the chips coming off. On the final cut, and you can sort of see the clean white part. We've taken about 30 thou off the radius, which is about 60 thou on the diameter, which is about a 16th of an inch, and it's actually running pretty true. You can see that it's pretty stable on that mandrel. This is the final cut, and it will get varnished.